Love, love, love. Peace, peace. Kaja Moss is celebrating those values and freedom in her Eurovision 2017 performance. Should we talk about it?
Let's do this.
Listen, I just have to say, when Deben Adarimi from Weeby Blogs and I said that Poland was an automatic qualifier she was going through, people were like, what are you talking about? No, it's not. Well, I'm sorry, we are justified because this rehearsal was fantastic. She has elevated this song. The song, whatever, it doesn't matter. This looks amazing, she sounds amazing, and the staging is very emotional and touching. Woman in white, pure, simple. At one point, you know, smoke comes out of the back of her and doves appear and fly. At the very end, the camera pans and you see the word freedom in white, blue stars. It's just very epic, actually. It's simple and yet epic. It's got a Polish identity. I think the patterning of the dress is very Warsaw textile. She's honoring Poland. She's honoring the world. She's honoring peace. She sounded great. I could go on. I'm not going to. I love you, Kaja.
Yeah, well, I had very low expectations for this beforehand because I didn't like the song at all. It's a very dark song that I don't know where she gets all the meanings about the animals and stuff from anyway, but the staging, when it starts, it's very, not quite mystical, but just feels something special. I was like, is something going to happen? And it's going so well, and then she starts going on about desire, fire, wire, and the illusion is lost. But it's definitely my personal favorite Polish entry since Cleo. Because as everybody who watches knows, I didn't like Michal Szpak last year at all. But she's a fabulous singer, her voice, and she looks fabulous on the stage. And the staging elements of it work really well. But coming straight after Greece, I think Greece with a similar style of song, they've done staging that bit better, that Cassie is just standing there and there's constellations whirling around, and at the start there was a violin and we were like, WTF is he there for? And but yeah, it's much better than I thought it was going to be, and I will be quite confident to say that we'll qualify.
Before I forget, the song sounds dark, and yet the visuals are light. Whereas in Poland, it was dark visuals, dark song, whereas this is dark, mysterious song and light, and I think that contrast works nicely.
I will say as well, so the very first run-through we saw was a bit of a letdown, if I'm honest, because they hadn't got everything right. And then each run-through, they nailed more and more camera angles, they got the lighting right. Initially, I found that the dress that she's wearing, it looked a bit washed out in terms of the lighting, but actually, again, by the final rehearsal, she looked really good. I'm still not a huge fan of the song, but I do respect it, and I really respect her voice. At the end of the day, I do think that this probably will qualify. I just think, I don't know whether I preferred the darker staging in the national final now.
I think this makes it more accessible. At one point, the dress is kind of see-through. There's a thigh split. And at one point, she turns and the lights go dark and she's backlit.
Yeah.
And so the light comes through the see-through dress, which is very dramatic. The freedom, normally I think that's cheesy to put the word freedom, but it's very subtle. It comes at the very end and it kind of pans to the word. And it's with that dramatic instrumental, and it makes it not cheesy, it makes it kind of inspiring.
You can do that right and you can do it wrong. I think like Basim did it horribly wrong, but this actually borders more on the doing it right version of that.
Did they minimize the violin player in the end?
He's just sort of like in the background. He's not a focal point of the song. It's very Gabriela Gunchkova in that regard from last year, it feels like.
The purple floor, they're purple constellations we didn't mention.
And it's like the stars, and there's some really great overhead shots. They definitely have thought about what they're doing here. I mean, Poland get what they're doing, really.
Yeah, I don't have much more to add. I think that it's a bit of a stretch to say that the freedom isn't cheesy, because a giant freedom on a blue screen is cheesy, but it's not kind of cringe-worthy cheese.
It's not cheddar, it's camembert, high-class cheese. In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? Are you excited to see Poland's full staging? Are you excited about the song and Kaja singing it live? Let us know here on Weeby Blogs.
And don't forget to like and share this video.
And subscribe.
And we will see you later. Bye!
Ciao!